Friends, today we are going to discuss about Gyarados service. I am Amit Gupta, assistant professor with the Chitkara School of Hospitality. Now in the Gyarados, what we are going to cover would be the introduction to the Gyarados service. Here we will talk about introduction and we will talk about history of the Gyarados service. We will talk about the approach to the Gyarados service and we will talk about MISA PLA for Gyarados service. These three scopes are the content that we are going to cover in the Gyarados service. Apart from that, we also look at the diagram of the Gyarados trolley and its dimension. When we talk about Gyarados service, it is a movable service trolley. If you look at the picture out here, it has got wheels. So it means it is meals on wheels inside a restaurant where the food is being carved, flambéed, filleted, prepared and served to the guest. In front of the guest. Now if you look at the picture out here, this is the dimension of the Gyarados trolley. The length of the Gyarados trolley is 123 inches. There is a hinge of around 30 inches to the top of the Gyarados trolley, which can move down or up, where we can keep the we can use for the MISA PLA. Below out here is the chamber where we can keep the calor gas or a gas cylinder to give the heat to the trolley. There is a cabinet in between and shelf in between to keep the MISA PLA for the service. The height of the Gyarados trolley is around 87 inches. Let's move forward. Let's talk about the history of the Gyarados service. The first flambéed dish was known as crepe suze. It was invented by the Henry Carpenter while working as a commis at the Café de Paris in the Monte Carlo in the 1794. This is the first dish that was prepared as per the record for the Gyarados service through the Gyarados trolley. Now let's talk about the approaches to the Gyarados service. Now it says Gyarados service is a term used in the restaurant business to refer to a trolley service. So it means a movable trolley which is used to provide service to the guest within the restaurant. Now the food could be carved, filleted, flambéed or prepared, which I told you. Apart from that, there could be a liquor trolley also. There could be a dessert trolley. There could be a spirit trolley. There could be any other type of trolley which is used to provide the service within a restaurant while the trolley is movable in nature. It's not stationary in nature. Now it talks about that, it says in terms of the approach, it says that food is either cooked, carved, filleted, flambéed or prepared in front of the guest. It is finished or present to the guest at a table from a movable trolley, which I told you earlier also. It is a form of entertainment also, because the person who is doing the preparation from the trolley, Gyarados trolley, is also doing the entertainment while preparing the dish. It stimulates the demand in our guest for the level of attention, because the more you do the entertainment in front of the guest, other people also feel that I should also have the same food. And it creates an atmosphere of sophistication inside the restaurant also, because the person who is doing is a professional and he knows what he is supposed to do and how he is supposed to do. Now when we talk about MISA PLA, this is a prototype. MISA PLA can change from what the kind of Gyarados service you are providing from the trolley. So for a basic Gyarados service, we need a service spoon and a fork. We need sweet spoon and a fork. We need soup spoon, teaspoon and coffee spoon. Keeping in mind what type of service are we providing, we need fish knife and fish fork. We need special equipment including a soup and a soup ladder in case there is a sauce or a soup that we need to serve along with the food, and we need a joint plate and a side knife and a joint knife also. This is what the MISA PLA talks about. Let's move forward in terms of the equipment that is being required. The first equipment when you talk about is a flare lamp. If you look at the picture out here, if you talk about this, it is similar to a lantern that we used to have it when I used to be very young. It's a modification of that, but it would be without a top glass. So there is one stand on which one chamber is in between, in which fuel is being filled, and there is one one funnel sort of thing which is being attached to it, and to that there is one screw which is being added attached to it, and to that attached is a wick. Wick is a cotton thread which is being attached, which is around 2 cm thick. Okay, now the screw that is being used is subject to increasing or decreasing the flame of the lamp. The fuel that is being used in the flare lamp is methylated spirit, which you can see in the blue form out here. Now it says the flare lamps would be cleaned with the aid of a powder on a regular basis. Trimming of the wick need to be done on a regular basis so that it gives even fire and does not give too much of smoke. Generally, the length of the lamp is around 20 to 25 centimeter in height and has a got a diameter of 15 to 20 centimeters. The next thing that we require is a Seffing disc or a Suzette pan. The difference between a Suzette and Seffing disc, Suzette pan has got a lip. It is a frying pan which is 23 to 30 centimeter in diameter. The lip is usually on the left hand side of the frying pan. It is made up of silver plated copper. So that why it is being used, because copper is a very good element and gives even heat to the plate. Okay. The next equipment that we use is a hot plate. It's a new technology that we use. It keeps the food hot. It is heated by gas, electricity or methylated spirit, and even with infrared ones. The calor gas is a gas cylinder which we use. It's a smaller gas cylinder that we fix it inside the trolley, which is fitted with a pipe and a gasket, so that it gives even supply of gas to the range. Okay, generally propane and LPG gas is being used to provide the fuel to the trolley. This is also one form of fuel that is being used in the Gerador trolley. Thank you. Anyone has got any question can ask me. Thank you.